Good afternoon, everyone. It's really my pleasure to have the opportunity to present the collaboration that Praxair has with the SMLC, Department of Energy, and University of Texas, among others. For those of you who doesn't know about Praxair, let me just spend 1 minute on this, and don't confuse with Pixar, because it has happened, okay? So, Praxair is one of the largest industrial gas companies. It's a Fortune 300 company, and in 2015 has almost $11 billion in sales. We have presence in more than 30 countries with 26,000 plus employees. And we have more than 1 million customers worldwide. We serve several industries, among them the manufacturing, metals, chemicals, electronics, among others. We service these customers basically in three forms. One, what we call packaged gases, that is distribution with cylinders. In United States alone, we have more than 10 million cylinders. We also have a large fleet of trailers, tractors to distribute the product. This is what we call merchant business. In the on-site business, our plants are next to our customers and we deliver through a pipeline. And just listening, Jim, right, that they have in more than 1 billion measurements per day. Actually, we have just in the on-site business 1 million measurements per minute. So you do the math, it's also quite a lot of data. So Praxair is interested in the smart manufacturing coalition because it shares similar vision in the analytics component, the analytics strategy. I know that all of you are very familiar with the big data, the types of data, what is the evolution of the business in order to arrive more to prescriptive and predictive type of modeling. So I will not spend too much of my time on that. I just want to mention that Praxair obviously takes very serious on this. And we have already quite a bit of applications in the predictive and prescriptive space, but we want to have much more. Now, in regards of the smart manufacturing and the DOE project, we both Praxair and the smart manufacturing share similar vision. Have measurements, sensing, have a smart, intelligent algorithms that in real time can help the decision on operations and business so that these decisions are better and faster. Before going to the results, I just want to spend a minute describing what is the problem, and I appreciate Tom already gives the heads up. As Tom mentioned, the heart of the one of the production facilities. Praxair has many production facilities in the hydrogen space. One of these is Port Arthur, and at the center of that is the steam methane reformer. You can see there, I think you cannot see the person there, but hopefully you can see there. The comparison is at least a four storage building. So it's really a large reformer. And the objective of this reformer is to transform the natural gas into hydrogen by means of going through a catalyst inside the tubes. There is 300 plus tubes inside the reformer, and the reaction is highly endothermic. So we need a large amount of energy to transform that natural gas into hydrogen. So you can appreciate that because of the size, the temperature distribution inside the reformer is not uniform. And that is what I wanted to illustrate in the lower plot. So when you don't perform energy balancing inside the reformer, you have usually a large distribution. So the intent is to narrow that distribution so that we can operate closer to the maximum temperature that is allowed. And in that way, save money, right? Have higher efficiency or true output. With the help of the Department of Energy and the Smart Manufacturing, we install eight cameras along the reformer. The objective was to maximize the coverage that those infrared cameras can, so that the measurements are as close as possible to the overall aspect on the reformer. So here I'm just showing a couple of images. In the right-hand side image, you can see a color code. There you can see the tubes, and in yellow you can see the wall of the reformer. You can see here what are the infrared images. And with these infrared images, it's given us millions of temperatures per minute. So then we can transform those measurements into maps, you can see here. And in red you can see what we call the hot spots. That is the reason it's difficult to balance the reformer, because even with a few of those hot spots, you tend to operate further from the maximum temperature that you could operate otherwise. So this is per se is a lot of information, is very good information, but that is not the thing we want to arrive. Together with University of Texas, we developed model-based algorithm that allows to manipulate the valves in the reformer. We have 90 plus valves on the reformer. And in that way, try to determine what is the optimal position of those valves. In the next slide, I'm going to illustrate a little bit some of the results. So here you can see what is the temperature distribution inside the reformer before balancing, and this was the valve positions. We have, as I mentioned, 90 plus valves, but we just move in sets of four for simplicity. Now, after having the algorithm run, et cetera, we can determine what are the optimal valve positions. And once we apply those into the reformer, then we obtain this temperature distribution. You can see here how narrow is the temperature distribution, and also that we can operate closer to the maximum temperature that is allowed. We embed all the algorithms into an automatic platform, and I'm going to just briefly mention that later on. But the platform has a very user web interface that the operator access, can run on demand these models. These models are refreshed, the results every hour. So this type of narrow distribution allowed us to have higher operation efficiency and improved reliability. And for Praxair, this is very high value. The last slide I want just to mention a little bit on the SMLC value proposition. As good as has been this test bed and the value that Praxair has gotten, we see in the medium and longer term, the SMLC will provide even larger value to us. I don't need to mention that, if you have a new application, you want to develop some other intelligence, more applications. It depends on the type of application you may need to have servers. In our case, sometimes it takes 6 to 8 weeks to get some servers. You had to involve procurement, you had to buy software, you had to involve IT, you had to involve a lot of people. With the SMLC, we see this as a one simple aspect in which we not only will be able to develop faster, but also we will be able to deploy and to replicate quickly. Praxair in the hydrogen space has 20 plus plants. In their separation site has 500 plus plants. So every application that we develop has to be replicated very quickly. And that is something that we see the SMLC will provide value.